There is breaking news on immigration right now, perhaps with a twist on it that we've never really experienced or heard about before. The Washington Post has it. It's just been posted. Quoting now from the lead, White House officials have tried to pressure U.S. immigration authorities to release detainees onto the streets of sanctuary cities to retaliate against President Trump's political adversaries, according to Department of Homeland Security officials in email messages reviewed by The Washington Post, end quote. Rachel Bade shares the byline on this. She joins us now by phone. Rachel, I haven't even had time to read this full article. Can you just walk us through your reporting, what this plan was? I guess it was from the White House to Homeland Security?
Happy to do it, Anderson. Yeah, it's a crazy story. Basically, we found out that Stephen Miller, who's one of the top White House hardliners on immigration, very close to the president, they leaned on ICE to consider this proposal where they would be moving undocumented immigrants they had captured at the border to sanctuary cities or the districts of adversaries like Democrats. And the one that was mentioned in particular was Nancy Pelosi, who's the Speaker of the House. This came twice. It came right after the election at a time when the caravan, remember the caravan that the president always talked about before the 2018 elections, they had just reached the border. So this talk started percolating around that time. And, you know, ICE was really alarmed by this. They seemed to ignore it at first and then sort of put it on the back burner. But it came up again right after the president decided to reopen the government following the 35-day shutdown in January. The president basically gave lawmakers 3 weeks to come up with this deal to fund the border. And one of the key issues they were debating was detention beds. Democrats wanted fewer detention beds for ICE. And so this came back, this idea was pushed again by the White House on ICE in February, right in the midst of these talks where Democrats were saying they didn't want to give these detention bed numbers to Republicans under the Trump administration. So ultimately, according to our reporting and the folks we spoke with, including two whistleblowers who actually came to Congress with their concerns, this never went anywhere because ultimately Democrats relented on the detention bed issue. Obviously, they didn't give the president the wall funding he wanted, but on detention beds, they relented. And also, several legal advisors in ICE found that there was no legal justification for doing this. And so, you know, they ultimately pushed back on the White House and said no. This notion of using migrants and trying to release them to create chaos on a political adversary, right. It's absolutely wild and unlike anything I've seen before.
Rachel Bade, it's extraordinary reporting. It's on the Washington Post site right now. You're also a CNN political analyst, we should point out. Thanks very much. Steve Cortez is back with us, along with Max Boot and Jeff Toobin. Jeff Toobin, what do you make of this idea?
Well, my first reaction was, huh? I mean, really? The idea of using these human beings as a kind of pestilence to spread around the country. I mean, it is so grotesque. You took the words right out of my mouth when you said, you know, these are human beings, and to treat them like a form of plague that you want to impose on your enemies is really grotesque. Now, I guess the good news we can say is that it hasn't happened, or at least it hasn't happened yet. But I think it's indicative of the attitude towards illegal immigrants or undocumented people, whatever term you want to use, as something less than human. And all I can say is I'm glad it didn't come to fruition.
Steve Cortez, I know this is the first you're hearing of it as well.
Right. I mean, look, I think you can probably understand that I'm obviously not going to accept the Washington Post word for it. So I want to see these emails. I want to see evidence of the story
assuming
they're talking about.
Assuming they exist and the whistleblowers are telling the truth who have gone to Congress, you don't want to assume anything.
I mean, I don't go down that road. You know, right. And I would say this, too, by the way. I don't believe we should be releasing anyone who crosses the border illegally, much less targeting where they're released. If you cross the border illegally, you should be detained.
Targeting specific districts for political enemies with illegal immigrants or undocumented workers, that is not something you would support, for what you're saying.
Not. Right.
Max Boot, I mean, when I first mentioned this to you while we were during a break, you said, like, you thought this almost it sounded like an article from The Onion, like so absurd that it couldn't be real.
No, exactly. It's hard to believe that somebody would take this as a serious proposal. Like a lot of stuff that happens in the Trump administration, you don't know whether to laugh or to cry. I mean, it is so ridiculous. And I think it indicates basically two things, Anderson. One is, A, the crazy level of partisanship in this White House. And the fact that the president is calling his enemies treasonous is an indication of the same thing, that they will stop at nothing to hurt their political enemies. But two, I think what it also indicates, Anderson, is their intellectual bankruptcy on the issue of immigration and how frantic and panicked they are, because there was a record number of undocumented arrivals in March, 92,000. Highest level in 12 years. They're freaking out in the White House. They don't know what to do about it. This is why Trump is lashing out. He's purging the Department of Homeland Security, but they don't actually have a workable policy solution. And that's why they're talking again about reviving this horrible idea of separating children or this crazy idea.
Got to get a break in. Max Boot, thank you. Jeffrey Toobin, Steve Cortez as well.